Yes, it's LDaVice, aka Trap Shady, playing Zelda. I'm going to be doing Walkthru, providing skip sequences where I share numbers and titles and tell you where to go, and if you don't want to watch the whole video, you can skip through it. A couple of places I provided a timeline for is King Goron is actually on this video. You can skip that and go to 2137 is the exact schematics for seeing that. Or you can go straight to the action and open the Dodongo Cavern at 3458. And so right now what I'm doing is I just bought this mask in the marketplace and I'm going to give it to this guard who needs to give it to his kid. And he's going to open the gate for me. I told him no way, just to see what would happen. And he closes the gate on me. I'm like, oh man. There's a lot of dialect in this game. I have to skip through this video. It doesn't take that long. 2 minutes tops. So other than the guard actually suggesting that I buy a Hyrulean shield, it would only make sense that you can't go into a flaming hot volcano defeating an enemy that shoots fire at you with a wooden shield, a Deku shield, from the forest. So logic dictates you gotta find a metal shield. It's in this marketplace. In fact, I'm about to pass the place right there on the left is where you buy it. You can buy that shield for 80 rupees. But because you talk to the guard, he gives you a discount. About 55 rupees. So now we're done with that. I think I just wanted to make sure there wasn't any other mask quests up here in Kakariko. But that's besides the point. We still have to go meet the Gorons. And we gotta figure out all their secrets. And then make our way into the dungeon. The acclaimed Dodongo Dungeon. There's a lot of convoluted names in this game. Kind of hard to say. I like the thing about Zelda Ocarina of Time especially is that it has a homey feel to it. You know, despite like it's not even realistic, it still feels like perfect in your living room, you know what I mean? It's like a book that you pick up and you start reading. And things just mesh together perfectly. I think if this was a book, it would be a bestseller, you know? Ocarina of Time, flat out. I'm not even sure if there was a book ever written. I'm sure if there was, though, this would be it right here. It would be just like this. All this on a cartridge. And no load screens, too, because it's a cartridge. Ever since they turned to CDs and CD-ROMs, everybody is, you know, everybody's got to deal with the loading screens. I don't think there's much you could do with a cartridge, though, in terms of, like, online capabilities and stuff. Okay. Anyway, so now we're in Goron City. This place can be a little bit confusing to the naked eye. But one thing you know is that your fairy will help you. When your fairy sees something, you're supposed to see something. That's what I did. I clicked on this guy. Okay, there's a guy waiting in there for me. So that's my cue to play a song. The royal song that Zelda taught me. This is the song of the triad, right? The three triangles. So it only makes sense that he'd open the door for me. This is the big Goron King. He's probably the most roughneck of the kings. Living in a dungeon, eating rocks. But he will definitely become a helping hand later on. He'll be the reason why you continue on with your quest, in essence. So you don't have to waste time like I do and smash everything up. Now, all you have to do at this part, I'm gonna go off and run around for like 5 minutes, not doing what I'm supposed to, but really what you're supposed to do on this part is play your song. You're not supposed to take that fire and go lit things up. You're supposed to take your ocarina and play the Kokiri song. If you play that for him, it reminds him of his friends, his other god friends from the forest. Don't play Zelda's song, play the other song. You got in with Zelda's song, you got access. Now play another song for him. And he will open up. And, I believe he has a gift for you. But this right here, you could just skip through all this until I go back downstairs and talk to him, because what I was trying to do here is, I was trying to figure out why that middle vase was spinning like that, and at one point I was trying to jump into it. I realized I couldn't do that, so basically what I'm doing is, I realize I gotta take bombs and throw them into the thing. I go through a lot of I got smart and I took my thing and I set one of the bombs on fire with the flaming stick. Like I said, this is a long process. You're supposed to just be playing the songs for the king. And what he does, the king gives you a bracelet. And it makes you stronger. And what the bracelet does is it gives you the ability to pull bombs out of the ground. So once you can do that, it's pretty simple. You just pull it out of the ground and you have freedom from now on with the bombs. You can put them anywhere you want. I fell down a few times on this. Yeah, like I said before, you might just want to skip past until you see me back inside the king's room, because there I will play him a song, and he will give me a gift. I believe it's called the Goron's Bracelet. I was just messing around. Sometimes I forget I'm not recording, and so there's also an element of me that wants to leave my legacy behind. You know, this is how I played Zelda. I'm gonna bring you through a walkthrough, but I'm not going to, like, you know, bore you to death with the pure detail of the game, you know. I like to do the discovery as well. I like to discover things as they go along as well. And besides, what fun is it if you're just running through the game, doing exactly as you're supposed to? There's no fun in that. This game's all trial and error. See, like this part. I lit the stick 3 times. Because I'm just trying to set these bombs on fire. And instead, I keep swinging my stupid sword. It's like, you forget you gotta press the C button. There we go. And I got smart, jumped down and lit those, and I found a little Goron shop. I got the Goron tunic. I don't think you can buy this yet though. I don't even have enough rupees to hold 200, or enough space. Bombs you get naturally later on anyway. See, I buy those. Oh. Yeah. They're giving you a chance to go find them naturally. They fall out of enemies and stuff. Bombs always... all kinds of stuff falls out of enemies. Basically, every ammo, any ammo that you have... seeds, sticks, you know, later on you get potions, all that stuff's gonna fall out of enemies. So, if you're looking for an extra heart, or you're looking for an extra deco seed, you should probably attack a bat, get in a fight with a bat, attack him, kill him, and then you don't have to worry, because everything's there for you. You just gotta... use the best of your knowledge. You gotta look around. You gotta be diligent. And this is literally me, if you're still following at this point. This is literally me running around all of Goron City. I haven't even played this game in like 7 years. Not remembering what to do. And I'm just kind of going through the motions. I think I throw one of those bombs in there a few times. Zelda on 64 really knows about trial and error aspect to this. You just gotta keep going, keep trying. You gotta look around, make sure you're aware of everything. Some things don't seem obvious to you until you look at it at a different angle. See, I go looking through my inventory. There's nothing there, though. Everything that I have is probably more than I should need to finish my quests. They're not going to make me do a quest and I don't have what I need. That's never going to be the case. Mostly it's about secrets and figuring out how to better use the equipment you have. And then sometimes there's technicalities. Maybe you can't open this. Maybe you can't pick this up. Figure out a way to pick it up. It's sitting right down there in the king's little office there, but I just haven't, in my mind, playing this game. It didn't dawn on me. I gotta go play that Kokiri song that's playing in the cave right there. The cave that I just exploded. Huh. Novel concept. So I get my ocarina out. This area. Peace. Hey, listen. Yeah, I know that. Thank you. Messing around with these rocks. Let's get something going here. He likes that one. And then he tells you, hey, wait, what about that Serious song that I've been hearing in my freaking cave? You play that one instead? So this game can become very convoluted if you're not carefully putting details and techniques into your head for later, you know what I mean, for future reference. Keep that in the back of your mind, and it could be used for later things in the game. And it's not always going to be apparent, you know. Oh, he's loving that. Of the Gorons. Flower picker-upper, the Goron bracelet. Ain't no big deal, you just slip it across your left wrist there and you're on your way. Now you can start picking bombs up, man, and carrying them to different places. And then here's where I commence to throw bombs into that base, like a basketball. This is heart-wrenching if anybody really doesn't like to watch the regular flow of a player. Instead, they want to see the secrets. Feel completely free to fast-forward through this, and I will not hate you at all, because I had a little trouble doing all this stuff. I blew up that guy, and then I blew up this door, and it's all pretty self-explanatory, really. But like I said, it's not for any sort of quest. I'm not finishing anything here. All I'm doing is getting a bracelet, and I'm gonna make my way to the top of Goron Mount, of Death Mountain. Actually, no, not top. First, I'm gonna go to the cavern, right? The cavern is the second dungeon, and it's right below the city. So, if there was a chart, imagine a chart with this mountain, okay? The bottom of the chart is a dungeon that you're supposed to enter to defeat an enemy. The middle is the city, Goron City. That's the middle of the mountain. The top of the mountain is the Great Fairy. The Great Fairy will give you powers if you clear out that dungeon at the bottom. So you're gonna go up and down on this one. That's why it takes an hour to complete. And I was, you know, my mind does not go outside and start doing this dungeon. My mind is, okay, I have a secret in front of me right here. Why not just take care of it while I'm here and do this? And so I met a giant Goron. Tells me come back in 6 years. Oh, okay. So I'm thinking Link is like 9 or 10. 9 or 10 is about the age. Kids are pretty wild and rowdy like this. So 5 plus 6. 5 or 6 plus 10. It's like 16. Link is like 15, 16 years old. Which doesn't seem like, it seems like he's a fully grown man. But, nope. They did this game right, man. They incorporated every emotion involved. Because they know what it's like to grow up, and they know what it's like to get old. It's that whole idea that when you finally grow old and you see how the world's changed. So they're sending you on a young Link journey to get you used to how things are now for young Link. And then old Link is going to be an all different sort of... Goron City won't be the same. Nothing will be the same as old Link. That's the whole point, you know what I mean? It's a perfect story. It's probably been written about, read about in books galore, but depicted in a video game on a console that was pretty brand new at the time. It was only 2 years old at 64. But to put this game out on a cartridge in which there's no load screens, it's smooth like this. I mean, I don't know if this game got Game of the Year, but it sure shit should have. Because this is a perfect game. Perfect video game depiction of a story, of a book. Like I said earlier, it could be a perfect book. And so I basically go on my little bomb tour here. I'm just trying to get it into that vase. But I'm so raw to this, I just didn't realize that there's a bomb over here. Right now, I'm playing on an emulator, and that is, that means I'm basically playing N64 through a laptop. And the last time I did that was, 2009. So I haven't done this whole link to N64 since, like, 7 years ago, when I was younger. And, you know, you don't really... you don't really recall everything that you've done, especially a big game like Zelda. You could play it, right? Beat it, start the beginning, and not remember everything that goes on. I mean, there's a lot of stuff that goes on in this game. And not at one point does it speed up or slow down, or, you know, make you leave you wanting more. It's just perfect. It's just a perfect game. I like to look up on the internet sometimes. I made it. I like to look up on the internet to see what type of reviews that Zelda had back in the 90s, what people thought of it originally. I want to see the oldest review of Zelda Ocarina of Time. I want to see the oldest one, what they said, and compare them to what they say about games nowadays. That's kind of what my new sort of liking to retro gaming is. That's why I have so many clips of like Donkey Kong and Gex the Gecko, all my favorite stuff that was on N64. When I was real little is when I used to play N64. It wasn't until I was, what, 10, I started getting PlayStation. And then I turned 11. It was all Xbox. Xbox, Xbox, Xbox. Couldn't get enough of it. Yeah, so these games got a little shrouded just by time. This game, it deserves to be played even today. Because it's just, everybody can learn something from it. Anyway, yeah, this is quite a long process here. I'll refresh you if you're still watching. Basically, what you're doing here is you're trying to walk into Goron City, speak to the guy. You learn that there's a bracelet to acquire. And you walk back outside where you came from. And see, I opened this up and there's a secret heart container in the base. That's why I was doing that. Anyway, recap. Came in, talked to the manager, or talked to the master. He gave you a bracelet. Now you're supposed to walk outside and go pick up one of those bombs and open the dungeon with the bomb. I'm going to show you how to do that. That's if I'm actually done screwing around here. It's nighttime, there's no big deal. You can still get anything done that you want to get done. As long as things aren't closed and people aren't asleep, you can do whatever you want at nighttime that you can do at daytime. The cavern is going to be a doozy. I'm just gonna put it to you right now. It's not easy. It takes forever. And you may need to skip through some parts just because either A, you don't want to ruin a story for yourself, or B, you just want to see something and then move on. Which is awkward. Look, I know. I hate watching people play. Trust me, I absolutely hate it. But because we don't have the best of technology to kind of split these videos up, and we don't have the manpower to do it, I'm giving you a raw version of what it's like to play this game on a console. This is exactly what it's like. This isn't a video I found. This isn't going on YouTube, cut and paste. This is my video. This is my clip of Zelda. Alright, so we're inside the cavern, Dodongo's Cavern. And because this is such a long dungeon, I'm going to suggest that you skip to either my fight with the Ludolfos at 44, or my fight with the statue Armos at 53. Otherwise, you can just watch the whole walkthrough, which I would also suggest because of a nostalgic purpose. It's fun to watch people play. If nothing else, you get to see a different style of gameplay, you know, other than your own. And plus, I have a cool little black suit on, a black tunic. Now, this part, it seems a little daunting at first. Especially if you don't know how to use the bombs, like I do. I didn't know anything when I was doing right now. See, I'm just kind of taking shots from the BMOs. I hadn't played this in a while, so. It said get smoke in his eye, so I figured, okay, I need a bomb. I have my bracelet so I can pick bombs up now. And I think that's what I'm gonna do. Of a waiting process. I have my C buttons. They're all set to like and like the right analog stick. So it's a joystick. I'm sorry, right joystick. It's kind of weird. It's not something I'm used to at all. You know, N64 had buttons. And I'm blowing up, oh boy. You just gotta keep calm, keep your wits about you, and don't do unnecessary things like roll into lava. Right, so if you're like me, the dungeon maps do you no good because you don't use them. I always like to adventure without looking at anything. I don't want to spoil it. Plus, honestly, it bores the heck out of me to look at maps. This guy right here, you gotta have your Deco shield out in order to even speak to these guys about anything. Take it out, right? Thinking to yourself, okay, let me see what this guy has. Why does he want to sell me a Deco shield? I already have one. You don't stop to think. If you have your Deco shield equipped, whether it's on your back or in your hands, if you are harmed by fire in any way, it will burn up, and you will lose it. And Deku shields, they're not all that sacred. I mean, they're quite plentiful, so you don't need to worry about, oh, I'll never be able to find one again, that's why they gotta sell them, right? So they're giving you a chance to spend your rupees. They want you to spend your rupees. So I'm gonna place a bomb. Oh. I'm quite the risk taker in this game. I never really shy away from a battle. Although this one, I think I'm gonna kinda just exit stage right. I think someone's trying to tell me something. You're not gonna do it, Lonnie. You're not gonna do it. Even the fairy's like, yeah, come attack this guy. Leave that other one alone. It's just a series of repetitive things. I wouldn't say repetitive. Maybe just meticulous things. And they want there to be an element of mystery, right? What adventure, what game would there be an adventure if there was no mystery, right? In fact, mystery is a good element for a lot of things. You gotta love the sound quality too. This laptop actually is an AMD quad core. Not that that has to do with the Dolby Digital. But yeah, it's a pretty good little Windows 10 touchscreen. I think I can play Zelda touchscreen. So right now, I'm trying to see what's up here, but it doesn't really, I don't know yet. I'll leave it alone. Open this door over here with these guys. Said before, the bats are great for hearts. Statues. We call those statues almoses. Well, Nintendo Nintendo calls them in the Armos. Sometimes they're real, sometimes they're fake. You can tell if one's real if all you do is stand by it and it turns red and chases you. I was about to say, man, I'm gonna die soon if I find some hearts. Here we go. The Lizalfos. You take from these guys. I like to just hide under my shield, let them hit, and then press A. Or B. Sorry. It's A if you have an Xbox One controller. Or actually, it's X. I use X. Very confusing. Simple. Hold Z, targeting system, hold it, and then you take your shield up. The whole time you're holding it, when you're fighting these guys, you want to hold it the whole time. They jump near you, you're holding Z, Z targeting. Fairy is in sync with you too. It's a whole timing thing with this game. Your fairy gets in sync, you press Z, and then you got a target going on. This looks like the same thing as before. Oh, that's because it is. Oh boy. This game can be like that sometimes. You can get lost. Seeds. Cause I need some seeds. I don't really find. That's the thing. Like, sometimes when you need a certain thing, you never get it. All right, these guys. I think they're called, yeah, Dodongos. I call these little Dodongos. Because there's a big one. so little, the Dodongos are basically invincible. What you gotta do? Shielding yourself doesn't work. However, when they throw their fire, they stand still, and that's when you attack from the back. And they explode, so watch it. I did an experiment. I tried to get one to light this candle. That didn't work. I repeat, it does not work. In case you want to be lazy, they don't let the Dodongo light it for you. They're like, no, you are killing these guys. No, I ain't. See, at first I thought I was real slick. I thought I was done. I was like, oh, cool. I got away from those Dodongos. Unscathed. I wonder if everybody loves Zelda. Alright, but everybody's heard of it or something. I wonder how everybody feels about it, you know what I mean? Like, do they honestly know that this is like the best game ever? I'm curious about a lot of things about this game. It's from my childhood, I mean. Really important time too in my life. It was really like a turning stone, you know? I'm like 6 years old. Yep, I was 6 years old. Alright, so this is the statue. Almost. Okay. I really don't know. This is why it's good to have a fucking partner in my fairy. See, now he doesn't know how to hurt me with this. Stuff. Nervous, dude. I don't know what to do. So I was just killed by some flaming bats, and we're back at the beginning of the Dodongo Cavern. I didn't lose any progress. I didn't even have to save, I don't think, because I had it externally saved to something else, so I'll never really lose progress in-game, whether I have a memory pack or not. But anyway, I'm gonna make my way to the giant Dodongo. And, do a little bit more exploring, see if there's any more chests and hidden stuff. So, because I include every walkthrough and all the secrets and the goodies, you can actually skip to an hour and 28 minutes to see the giant Dodongo fight for basically the conclusion of this dungeon and how you win your ruby fire gem from Karunia. I believe his name is Karunia. The fire, or the Goron headmaster. So after I defeat the first two Lizalfos, there's going to be another set of Lizalfos right before the boss sequence. So there's a few more puzzles you gotta complete before you actually fight the giant Dodongo in this dungeon. It's pretty straightforward. There's nothing too confusing about this one. I'm just gonna take this bomb, blow up all these other bombs, and the stairs fall and collapse. There we go. Sometimes this game reminds me of Tomb Raider. I wonder if they had any inspiration from that. Slowly climb. At the top of these steps are three armosts and two flaming bats inside. I know, because I believe I died after this part. Oh no, it's a different part. This is how we progress through and get to the giant Dodongo eventually. Alright, so these guys are tricky at first, the Armos. They bounce at you and bounce at you, but really you just want to put a bomb in front of them and run away. And they'll jump over it, and then you just hide under your shield while they're hurt. See, when they're spinning, they're hurt. And I can't be attacked by them if I'm under my shield. That's pretty much like the Lizalfos. You can't be hurt by them if you just use your shield. Always use your shield. Killed here, let's just get over this bridge. Alright. I get new one. Alright. So this part looks pretty problematic. I use the targeting to straighten out my camera as well. That's how you're supposed to do it. It's kind of like a panning system, or like an RB mechanism on the Xbox One, except it's Z. Z is a broad thing in this game. The secret heart back here. I'm gonna climb on top of this block. Saw a chest up here. This could take a few tries. It's kind of like basketball. Oh. How you like that? That's Link, baby. That's Link for ya. Gotta make sure I have some Deku seeds. Running out of Deku seeds in this game, it's almost like breaking a sword, you know what I mean? Once you run out of that weapon, you can't progress with some of the some of the passageways and puzzles you can't complete without hitting them with your slingshot. There's just meticulous little things you gotta pay attention to. The Lizalfos, part 2. Alright. So it's more targeting system. And shield, shield, shield. Hit you, you attack, shield. My button is on the Z targeting the whole time. I'm fighting these guys. And it's funny, these guys need the Z targeting. You don't even need to Z target the boss. The giant Dodongo doesn't require Z-targeting at all. In fact, all you gotta do is step out of the way for him. Just move out of the way and you're done. To give you a technical boss battle, so to speak, right before the boss. See, the Deku Tree, you got almost nothing in terms of a henchman before the boss. You got almost nothing. You got little tree shrub looking dudes that shoot seeds at you. And that was about it. You gotta shoot them in order. Which, any seasoned gamer knows that that was basically like butter. Beating those guys and getting even the boss was like butter. I mean, it was pretty easy. But, you know, that's how they wanted to design the game. Wanted to make an easy first boss. And then up the challenge a little bit. Give you the Dodongo. There we go, I found a chest. We shall see what's inside. Nice. Yes, I will take 20 bombs, thank you. That's a lovely gift. Let's open this door, would it? I think they blow up faster, too. Out your Deku shield to bounce these things off. If you use your metal one, the seeds that are coming at you, incoming, they will break. So you gotta use your Deku shield. I never buy anything from these guys. They're just rip-off artists. I wonder why they have these guys scattered around the maps, though. Nobody ever buys anything from them. And plus, that's a lot of rupees. 40 rupees for 30 seeds. I mean, it's like... So I don't really know why they sent me back out here. This metal thing's destroying me. Have no fear, this game will confuse you, and it will test your mind. It'll probably strengthen your mind, too. You gotta think a game with all these puzzles and secrets, you gotta think that it's strengthening your mind to even complete these things. Hard to believe it's a 20-year-old game. Almost. In 2 years, it'll be 20. I feel like I'm supposed to be out in that elevator room with all those elevating pillars. This is my journey, though. This is how I play the game. I usually do pretty much make sure that I'm not missing anything anyway, so it doesn't matter I'll always make, double takes and do once overs on all these places just to make sure I'm not missing anything, because these types of games always have secrets, they always got things going on in them. Got a lot of detail, you know. You'll miss something from the get-go. As soon as the game starts, you'll miss something. Some sort of secret. That's how many there are. Yeah, see, that was just stupid. And plus my shield, oh my god. Why would you do that? What did I think? I can shimmy across the edges there? Is that what I was trying to do? Okay. It would be great to shimmy along sides of edges and stuff. That's the one thing you can't do in this game. But hey, I ain't complaining. I am not complaining at all. This is a very 5-star game. Without a doubt, 5 stars. I wonder if I should record every chapter of this game. What are we gonna do? Do a voiceover. Do a walkthrough. Post it online. I wonder if people will actually watch them. I mean, it's not like I just give you a full boring video and I don't give you schematics and numbers for you to skip into the scenes. It's like you can either watch it leisurely with me, or you can skip to this boss battle, see how I do it, see how I get through it. That's how I think it's, I believe it's an ideal thing that I'm doing. Because so many of these videos you watch, and you're like, okay, this guy's going to make me sit through all this gameplay. Me, I'm giving you a skip number. I'm telling you, hey, go ahead and go past me here. There's a lot of gameplay. Games take hours. These games really do take hours to play. Very long time. Oh, this part, man. They're just trying to screw me here. Come on. Oh my... Dude, the C buttons are analog on my stick. The right stick. So I am just having all sorts of trouble trying to do this. I finally found 5 Deku Seeds. And I just can't open this one stupid door. That's part of the fun, though. You can see the danger of what I'm going through in-game. I'm not just flying through every mission, you know. Previously played this for, you know, 10 hours to get all the secrets down, and I memorize them all so I don't mess it up. I'm not going to sit here and bore you with the raw detail of everything. I want you to see my journey and how I would play Zelda back in the day. This is exactly how I'd play it as a kid. Nothing has changed at all, except my tunic is black. Alright, so... something's gotta give here. Alright, here we go. Yeah, I knew something was up, man, dude. I could look up and see that there's like, bridges at the top. So I knew you'd have to go up here eventually. That skull reminds me of Conquer Bad Fur Day. I don't know why, but I feel like I have to be over here. Huh.
Well, what do you know?
Everything works out for the best. I like McCray from Overwatch.
It's high noon.
Wow, I'm actually on the skull. I don't know what I did here. Oh, yeah, this goes all the way up. Bridges as soon as I entered the dungeon. Initially, I saw these bridges up here. I knew you had to go up here. Pots up here. This is a long and like meticulous dungeon, if anything. Deku tree is really small. So it turns out, I actually needed this guy. This weird little dude in the ground, I needed. I needed him to sell me Deku seeds for 40 rupees. I thought I was crazy at first. I was like, man, I'll never need these. Sure enough, I ran out. My freaking aim, man. It's not always perfect with this targeting system. Because in all reality, it's not really a targeting system. Actually, the Z targeting is mainly like an... Maybe it's an army a targeting system. But the slingshot with the C, that has no aims. There's no aim system on that. It's just literally... hope that you hit it, basically. Alright, I think everything's coming to a head. I want to see something up here. Try it out. Something about eyes glowing. So let me. Yep. I wonder if you could do that from the get-go. If you could just spawn up there and somehow just open that gate immediately without even having to fight the Lizalfos. Alright, so this part... I don't know why I had that. Again, 1 hour 28. So it's 1 hour 28 minutes is actually the beginning of my Dodongo fight. And you're absolutely free to skip towards that. Or you can hang along and journey with me. I don't know which way I came in. So if I came in the short way, I know I didn't come in through the barred door. The barred door is what I'm trying to open. I thought I came in this way. Right? Oh, I see. There's two openings. So you gotta be diligent. Watching this is probably like nerve-wracking for like the Zelda aficionado. See, I didn't notice this tunnel when I walked in. This is just so weird to me. What is this? Get that fairy. That was a red fairy. Ah, it wraps around. Thank you. guys are gonna annoy me until they die. When those guys are in the air, it's like so hard to use Z-targeting.
Almost mind-numbing.
Finally. Let's get this done. The video has been going for an hour and 30 minutes. Crap. It's almost like real life. Yes, it's Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time is like real life. Might as well be. I'm gonna play it later today after I do this video. Yeah, boy. I got bombs. Gee, I wonder why I have bombs. Maybe should I plant one here? No, I took no damage. Oh. Okay. What do we have here? Dodongo infernal dinosaur. I wonder if I can implement those bombs somehow. Oh! So his fire bounces off walls. I'm like, okay. Taking a piss on me. So basically, looks like I'm gonna have to throw these bombs into his mouth. I said I don't use Z-targeting, but I guess it's easier. Just hit him once. I really gotta avoid that. That's really cool. That was a really cool ending for that guy. Lovely. So four of those equals one heart. You gotta collect four. think that's really cool how they got him. They got the lava drying up around him, and he's kind of stuck in there. That was a really cool boss battle. Alright, so now that I'm done with that scene, you can go ahead and, if you want to, skip to an hour and 40. And that's where I climb the top of Death Mountain, and I meet the fairy goddess of power, and I get my new power up. I'm loving this. I don't know why. I've never seen anything like that, even in new games. I've played Overwatch, Doom, all kinds of games. Dude's like, I got your package, man. I got your package right here. It's right here, right? Just jumps out of nowhere. Alright, so we're done with that dungeon. I believe my reward is coming up. Ganondorf. People recognize that you risked your life in real life. Give you a great big hug and a gem from the sky. Successfully completed the Dodongo Cavern, the second dungeon in the Zelda Ocarina of Time storyline. And I believe I have one more destination before this video concludes. I'm gonna go see that great fairy at the top of Death Mountain. See what kind of power up she's got for me. I don't know if I would be so scared of the Gorons, but I guess the 90s, who knows? They might be scary in the 90s. Actually, when I used to play Spyro the Dragon, there'd be some points in the game as a kid where I'd have to turn down the volume completely just to play the game, just to get through it. I don't know why, but I heard like this weird alarm sound that would go off when enemies would appear, and I would have to lower the game volume just to play it and get through it. So I can understand and being scared of the Gorons. They look nice, but they might be scary. Bombs. Ah! Got some bombs. So this is pretty simple. I'm just going to clear this passageway here. Climb the rest of this mountain. That was pretty seamless. Looks like a lawn. Just the most unusual thing I've ever seen. A lawn in a cave on Death Mountain. Okay. I even tried milking this thing for lawn milk, and I don't think that worked. Shield on right now. Feels like a mountain too. Hello, Mr. Owl. How are you? You come to give me a hoot hoot? Set a bomb here, you know. There she is. The fairy goddess. Great Fairy of Power. Oh, this is cool. So I get a charge spin attack. It has two waves of charge. One is like a blue charge, and the second is an orange charge wave. Blue to orange, the longer you hold the B button. And it actually uses magic, so now I'm gonna have a magic meter. It's basically the beginning of opening the can of whoop-ass on Hyrule. once you go get past the Dodongo Cavern, it starts going downhill from there. It gets really fun. Bye-bye, fairy goddess. Golly. I love my new powers. Alright, Mr. Owl, where are you? Basically concludes my Goron City Dodongo Cavern video walkthrough, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. I hope I was able to give you a helping hand, and you should definitely come back and check out my videos. I will give you all the schematics and all the numbers to skip any scene that you don't want to watch and get right into the action. I will be doing, I hope I'll do some more chapters. I think I like doing these little videos and walkthroughs. They're fun. It brings me joy to help people and to, you know, show them what games I play and at the same time help somebody. This is a hobby of mine, really, so it's no sweat off my shoulders. Alright, I think I'm done here.